أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear brothers, dear sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Welcome to Islamic Center of Reseda. We're still in our journey with the Holy Quran. I am asking Allah سبحانه وتعالى to accept it from us, يا رب العالمين. إن شاء الله we are in episode number 4 from سورة الحج. إن شاء الله we'll start tonight from verse number 7. We ended last night with قوله تعالى what Allah سبحانه وتعالى said ذلك بأن الله هو الحق وأنه يحيي الموتى. That Allah سبحانه وتعالى is the truth, is powerful, and He is the one who will سبحانه وتعالى عز وجل, He is the creator and He is the one He brings dead to life again, and He is capable to do everything. Verse number 7, وأن الساعة لا ريب فيه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still talking about the hour, the day of judgment, the resurrection day, for those who are denying that day. وأن الساعة آتية لا ريب فيها وأن الله يبعث من في القبور. And that the hour of doom, the hour of doom, الساعة, has to come. There is no doubt about that. In which there is no doubt. And that Allah will raise up again all those in the graves. Subhanallah. Look at this ayah. For those who are denying resurrection after death. Allah, even they said that in Surah Saffat, verse number 16-17. أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا أَإِنَّا لَمَبْعُثُونَ أَوَ آبَاؤُنَا الْأَوَّلُونَ. Do you think after we die and we'll be rotten bones and dust, turab, God will resurrect us again, even our parents too, grandparents. They are like surprised, they are denying that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is answering them, subhanahu wa ta'ala, telling them, yes, I will bring you back from your graves after your death. Because He is the only one, or Almighty Azza wa Jal, He created them and He is capable to bring them back to the light. And Allah said in Surah Ar-Rum, verse number 27, وَهُوَ الَّذِي يَبْدَأُ الْخَلْقَ ثُمَّ يُعِيدُهُ وَهُوَ أَهْوَنُ عَلَيْهِ. He is the one who invent, He is the one who start the creation, and He is the one who will bring them back, and this is easy for Him. Why He said this is easy for Him? In reality, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to us according to our mentality or the limit of our understanding. If Allah created you from nothing, He is not capable to bring you while He did create you before, means it easy for Him. To be honest, both easy for Allah, but Allah is trying to tell us, according to your understanding, if I make this and I destroy it, I can make it again because I make it before. That's not a big deal for me. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just giving us example. But anyway, everything is easy for Allah. There is nothing is called hayyin or ahwan ala Allah. Or there is nothing called sahr or ashal ala Allah. Easy or easiest. No, it's all easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah. He said, وَأَنَّ السَّاعَةَ آتِيَةٌ. The hour of doom has to come. There is no doubt that there is no doubt at all. وَأَنَّ السَّاعَةَ آتِيَةٌ لَا رَيْبٍ. There is no doubt about لا شك. لا رَيْب means what? لا شك. Well, it is سَاعَةَ الْقِيَامَةِ. That hour which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised us, which is the day of doom. سَاعَةَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And in that day, when that day will come, after resurrection, we will be gathered all together for the accountability, for the حساب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will count us. And He is the one who will give the final decision for all people. The final decision, وَإِلَيْهِ يُرْجَعُ الْأَمْرُ كُلْ لَهُ الْحُكْمُ وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. It's the final decision with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all of us. Yes, not in the hand of a king or a president or sultan or batikh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the one who's going to give the final decision. له الحكم وإليه ترجعون سبحانه وتعالى. And Allah is talking to those who are denying البعث, the resurrection day. فلا بد, it's must for people to stand from their graves. وأن الله يبعث من في القبور. And Allah will raise up again all those in the graves. سبحان الله. فالله is حق, هو يحيي ويميت, who brings people to life, who caused them to live, and who caused them to die. And he is capable for everything. وأن الساعة آتية لا ريب فيها وأن الله يبعث من في القبور. طيب. We, خلاص, we believe in that, that there is a resurrection day, there is a day of accountability, يوم الفصل. And that day Allah سبحانه وتعالى will account everybody, will be in the court of Allah. And to Allah is the final decision, سبحانه وتعالى. And all of us, our return is to Allah عز وجل. وإليه ترجع. Let's see the verse number 8 now, 9, 10 with me tonight. Three verses. I have title for, actually for until verse 16, but the same title for these verses. The argument of the transgressors and what they worship. Argument again. Actually, the surah started here with arguments. يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said verse number 3. Allah repeated again in verse number 8. But it's not the same way. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَجَادِلُ فِي اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ وَيَتَّبِعُ كُلَّ شَيْطَانٍ. Those who are making arguments about Allah, that the atheists, those who are in doubt about Allah, those who are denying the unseen, without knowledge, and they are following their shaitan. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking, verse number 8, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ, some of the people, مَنْ يُجَادِلُ فِي اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ وَلَا هُدًى وَلَا كِتَابٍ مُنِينٍ. Remember when I was talking yesterday about the three things, tools. If you have them, you can make arguments with someone. If you don't have any one of them, at least one or two of them, don't make arguments with them because I'm sorry, you are jahil. If you want to argue with somebody, you have to have ilm. Ilm means ilm istidlali. Or huda from kitab or something. Or wahi, kitab al-munir. Anyway. And among the people, those who argue about Allah with no knowledge, ilm, no guidance, huda, and no clear enlightening book, like kitab al-wahy, يعني, revelation, wahy. طيب, see this ayah, number 8. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was talking in the beginning of the surah, verse number 3, about those who argue without knowledge, without good maw'izah, admonition. We said, when you argue, you have to have something called العلم البدهي. العلم الايه؟ البدهي. Make sense. Yes. And our علم استدلالي عقلي. If you have logic to judge your judge, your عقل will judge this. Or علم بالوحي, the revelation. The people of الجدل, those who are making السفسطة or الجدل البيزنطي or that arguments without benefit, these people, they don't have any one of these. علم or guidance or revelation. They don't have nothing. Or fiqh. فأهل السفسطة بدي يقول الجدل عقيم. There is no benefit. فالعاقل عليه أن لا يجاري هؤلاء السفهاء. You say somebody is a fool like these people. He's trying to make arguments with you without knowledge. These people, my advice and what the scholar said, do not sit with these people and do not open the door for them. Even to argue with them. Because first of all, they're going to make you nervous. Second, they're going to make you crazy. Third, they're going to waste your time. Fourth, this is for no benefit. Maybe they're going to harm you. But it's better when you see somebody ignorant, he's trying to make argument with you, or safsata, or trying to show he has knowledge while he has nothing. Block the door from the beginning. Give him your back ala tul immediately. Don't open the door for him. Why? Because it's a headache for nothing. A headache for nothing. Let's see. Sayyidina Ibrahim is the best example in Surah Al-Baqarah about that. When Namrud ibn Kan'an was arguing with Sayyidina Ibrahim. And Allah said that in Surah Al-Baqarah. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِي حَاجَ إِبْرَهِيمَ فِي رَبِّهِ أَنْ أَتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْمُلْكِ إِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَهِيمُ رَبِّيَ الَّذِي يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتُ قَالَ أَنَا أُحْيِي وَأُمِيتُ قال إبراهيم فإن الله يأتي بالشمس من المشرق فأتي بها من المغرب فبهت الذي كفر والله لا يهدي القوم الإيه الظالمين. See this ayah. Allah is telling رسول الله, didn't you see يا رسول الله what happened to Ibrahim with the Namrud? The Namrud was making arguments with him. He was arguing سيدنا إبراهيم. He argued him. And because Allah gave him the kingdom, he was strong because of his kingdom, he was thinking he's a very powerful man. Actually, Nimrod, he called himself a god like Pharaoh. Same thing. He used to worship Shaitan. Nimrod, he said to Ibrahim, he said, my God is the one he caused people to live and to cause them to die. The only one can do that, Allah. And Nimrod said, I can do that. Safsata. What's Safsata? Arguments for nothing. He said, I can do that. In reality, he did not do it. He said, get me two people from jail. Kill this man and let this man go free. Aho, see, ana uhyi wa ummi. Aho, I cause somebody to die and somebody can be free. Life, I give him life. Of course, this is not in reality. This is not, saraha, this is tahreek, this is joke. لأنه لم يفعل فعل حقيقة الموت ولا حقيقة الحياة. He did not really give somebody حياة, life. And he did not really kill someone. سبحان الله. فإبراهيم عليه السلام, Allah gave him logic. He was very, يعني really the prophet of logic, سيدنا إبراهيم. He told him, طب okay, come to me, يا حمار, يا غبي. Listen. Allah سبحانه وتعالى brings the sun from the west. I'm sorry, from the east. Can you bring it from the west? إن الله يأتي بالشمس من المشرق. المشرق the east. Can you bring it from المغرب, from the west? فالنمرود, he was in confusion, without answer. فبهت, he was quiet. خلاص, that's it. سيدنا إبراهيم, he gave it to him. That's it. يلا. You play with me with the first one, which is not real. The sun is here, comes from the east. Can you bring it from the west? فبهت الذي كفر. That's it. Done. فالله سبحانه وتعالى here said, this kind of man, those who are arguing without any right, without any proofs, without knowledge, without any wahi, without any revelation, what they are doing? Because they have no proof. When they see somebody try to defeat them with the knowledge, they turn their back to him. ثانية عطفه, just to go away, لا ليضل عن سبيل الله, له في الدنيا خزي ونذيقه يوم القيامة عذاب الحريق. Look at this ayah. What he's doing? خلاص, لكن نمرود with سيدنا إبراهيم. Now سيدنا إبراهيم, he gave it to him. Allah brings the sun from the east. Can you bring it from the west? And Namrud, he was in confusion and he gave his back to Sayyidina Ibrahim and he left. طيب. Allah said about this man, turning his neck in arrogance. In arrogance. Away from the truth. To prevent others from following the way of Allah. طيب. Why he gonna prevent the others? Because if he make arguments with, for example, with Sayyidina Ibrahim, and the man comes to himself and he said, Wallah, you're right. Your God, he can do that. I cannot do that. Now, he's a good man, but he wants to escape, not to show people that he's been defeated or weak, because his mission is to misguide others. He doesn't want to show people that he's weak, he's been defeated, and he has no hujjah, no proof, and he's stupid and dumb. But that's why he escaped before people will see his shame. But that's why he escaped. He wanna show himself to them all the time, I am the one. To misguide them, to mislead them, to take them away from Allah. Those transgressors will be disgraced in this life. In this life, Allah will humiliate them. They will be disgraced. Also, they will have suffer. وَنَذِيقُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عَذَابَ الْحَرِيقِ. They will have suffer and torture in the hellfire. On the day of judgment. Look at this ayah. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is explaining the condition of that man. He is misguiding others and he has no proof, no knowledge, no fiqh, no ilm to argue. Like in Namrud and Sayyidina Ibrahim. Allah said, Thaniya atfi. What is atfi? Atfi, his side, his jam, this side. He's not back. Back is zahr. Al atf, his jam, this side. When I talk to somebody like this, and he defeated me, or he say something, I don't like it, I give him my back. I don't want to look at him. This is my back, my side. I give him this, طيب. الإنسان, when you look at him, any insan, he has head, and he has neck, and he has back, zahr, and he has two shoulders, and he has two sides, janibain. And from this, all of this, which is his body, you can see his movement or his reaction. If he's happy, look at his face. If he's sad, look at his face. If he's mad, look at his face. And subhanAllah, if he loves you, he'll come completely to you. If he hates you, he don't like what you do, he's going to give you his back and his neck with arrogance. Of, you know, you're going to see all of the movement of the insan. So his motion and everything, in his face, his body, his movement of his hand, his sadr, his back, and all of that. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us the picture. Then يَعُطْفِهِ He start because somebody defeated him. He has no knowledge. عَلَى رَيْلِ الْمَسْرِينَ خُدُونَ بُسْطَ لَغْلِبُوكُمْ يعني raise your voice and shout because otherwise if you do not that, they're going to defeat you. These people, stupid people. You know, they have no proof, no knowledge, no ilm, no fiqh to argue with them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying this kind of people الَّذِي يُجَادِلْ بَغَيْرَ عِلْمٍ He's argue without knowledge. When he is about to be defeated back from you because you have knowledge, you give him the proofs. He has nothing of that. He's going to start turning his side from you away and his neck. يلو راسه كده away from you, his neck. Subhanallah. Because he don't like what you're saying. Because he's bankrupted. He has no knowledge. He's zero. He cannot stand against you. But he's going to escape. And he has no proofs, he has nothing in with him except just to go away from you. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. And they said, لِيُضِلَّ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ to misguide people, to take them away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Well, the arguments with the jadal, the worst of it, something called al-mira in Arabic. يبقى الجدل when you argue with someone. The worst of it, al-mira. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He said, Allah will guarantee in Jannah a house in the top of Jannah, another house in the middle of Jannah, the third house in the bottom of Jannah, to the one who is leaving al-mira is not arguing. Even if he has the right with him, he just leave it. He's going to have these three houses in Jannah, in the top, in the middle of the bottom of Jannah. Why? Because he doesn't want to argue even the truth with him. He has all right. But just because arguments can lead to killing or fighting or harming. Imagine that you argue with someone, he's mad, you're mad, he's mad, maybe he's some, in the end, they're gonna shoot each other. This is how shaitan will come with arguments. That's why you don't argue with your wife, even if you are right. Yes, wallahi, because more you make arguments with her, that's hidden for you. Nobody can stand against women. Yeah, women, they have tongue like this. They can stand all the day shouting against you. But it's better just to keep it and ma'a salam, assalamu alaikum. Salam alaikum, nahna btaghi jahili. Bas, just go away. That's al-jadal, the worst of it, al-mira. Al-mira, Allah said it in Surah Al-Najm, verse number 12. He said, أَفَتُمَارُونَهُ عَلَى مَا يَرَى Are you arguing with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for what he saw in Isra' al-Mi'raj? Al-Isra' al-Mi'raj. والمراء والجدل الشديد عند المراء مأخوذ من كلمة مري الضرع يعني ايه مري الضرع المري when you know the udder of the cow when you milk it to the end until there is no drop of milk in it it's called you make مري الضرع means يعني اسكناع عن الجدال الشديد سبحان الله القرآن الكريم also He's telling us about that kind of munafiq. He's making arguments out of his kibr. وإعراض عند الحق عن الحق. He rejected الحق. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Munafiqun, verse number 5, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالَوْ يَسْتَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ لَوَّوْ رُؤُوسَهُمْ وَرَأَيْتَهُمْ يَصُدُّونَهُمْ مُسْتَكْبِرُونَ If someone is telling the munafiq, the hypocrites, The hypocrite person. Come, Rasulullah will ask Allah forgiveness for you. What they do out of their arrogance? لَوَّوْ رُؤُسْ They can turn their head, their neck means yeah, like this away. No. And they're gonna reject this person with arrogance. فالخطوات والإعراض started with what? البداية لي الرأس. If he don't like you, he's gonna turn his face and his neck like this away from you. Number two, he's gonna Turn his side, his neck first and his face, then his side, and then he's gonna give you his back. So completely he's gonna ignore you. And then he's gonna run away from you because he cannot stand against the truth. وعلة ثاني الجانب، العلة ثاني عطفه because he want to misguide people and he want to take them away from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. What is the punishment of this kind of people? Those who are misguiding others, they are arrogant, they did not accept the truth, they make arguments for الباطل، السفسطة والجدل الفاضي، wasting your time. And these people لهم في الدنيا خزي. الله سبحانه وتعالى he said these people they will be disgraced in this life، خزي في الدنيا، they will be humiliated، nobody gonna love these people، هون والذلة. And this is what happened to the kuffar in, of Mecca in the Battle of Badr. What happened to them? They were arrogant, they're gonna kill Muhammad and. When the Battle of Badr comes, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, who was carrying something in his hand like this, and they said, here Shaybah will be killed, here Abu Jahl will be killed, here Utbah, here Rabi'ah will be killed. And he started, صلى الله عليه وسلم, before the battle, showing where is the spots of each one of them going to be died and be killed. See, this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala humiliated them. And look what happened, how Allah humiliated the Pharaoh of this ummah. Who is the Pharaoh of the ummah of Rasulullah? Abu Jahl, right? That man, when he was fighting Rasulullah in the battle of Badr, what did he do? He used to have too many soldiers just to defend him. He's riding the horse, too many abid, slaves around him. He's in big halaqa, he's not fighting himself, he's just one to one. No, nobody even can come touch to him. And two little, Ibn Afra, two sons, little boys, one, they hit him and he's still alive, but he been injured, he cannot stand. And what happened? Look how Allah humiliated him, Abu Jahl. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Yemeni guy, subhanAllah, like Magish 20 pound, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Very short, skinny man. And his knife is not working. He's not sharp. When he saw Abu Jahl laying on his blood, but he's still alive, he started jumping above his chest. Abu Jahl كان بغل كده, like fat and tall and بغل, like a buffalo, you know? But he couldn't stand because he's in his blood, but he's still alive, he can talk. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, one day he was reciting the Quran around the Kaaba. He was the first one who was reciting Surah Al-Rahman. Abu Jahl slapped him and he cut with the knife one of his ears. Abdullah's ears. And he slapped him. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he did not forget about this. When he saw Abu Jahl, he was jumping above his chest. It's small, tiny, start jumping above his chest. And Abu Jahl, and he start shaving, cutting his neck. But the knife of Abdullah is not working. It's not sharp enough. It was harming him, Abu Jahl. And Abu Jahl told him, لَقَدْ اِرْتَقَيْتَ مُرْتَقًا صَعْبًا يَا رُوَيْعِيَ الْغَنَمْ يَخْرِبْ بَيْتَكْ. انت, ولا, انت, تفو صدري. You're standing above my chest. You are just a little shepherd of sheep. You are a little shepherd. رويعي الغنم means not even shepherd. رويع تصغير راعي. راعي means the shepherd. رويعي little, the one who is walking with the shepherd. Are you standing above my chest? This is something يعني high for you. يا خربان, take my knife and kill me. And Abdullah Mas'ud, first he cut his ears, one of his ears, one by one. And then he cut his neck. And his head was like a big watermelon like this. Rasulullah was sitting in his tent. Subhanallah, and Abdullah, the head of Abu Jahl is heavy for Abdullah. Abdullah is tiny, his body. He used to carry his head Abu Jahl and he used to walk. And he used to take some rest and he used to walk and he take some rest until he went to Rasulullah with the head of Abu Jahl. Rasulullah said, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. This is the Pharaoh of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this man. He hurt Rasulullah a lot in Mecca. And what happened? Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم was laughing to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم told him, يا Abdullah, أذن بأذن, ear by ear, and the head is extra, Abdullah. والرأس زيادة. سبحان الله. And this is what happened. فالله سبحانه وتعالى he humiliated this kuffar in the battle of Badr. And سبحان الله. And look what happened in فتح مكة. When the Rasulullah sallam entered Mecca with 10,000 soldiers and the Ansar with their banners, strong riding horses, strong soldiers, they enter Mecca. And Abu Sufyan, during that day, Al-Abbas, the uncle of Rasulullah, convinced him to enter Islam. عند وين أبو سفيان هو زي ليدر في مكة، هذا بيج مان، وين يسوي رسول الله with his army. He said يا عباس يا عباس لقد أصبح مع ابن أخيك يعني قوة، لقد أصبح ابن أخيك قويا، your nephew became very strong. يا عباس he has a big kingdom. And العباس told him يا أبو سفيان it is not the kingdom, it is the prophethood. It is the prophethood. He is a prophet. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supported him. النبوة المؤيدة من الله. Allah supported his prophet. This is not the kingdom or that will like what you see. فسبحانallah, now he corrected him. Also, when the kuffar of Quraysh, they became Muslimin, and those who were weak, the slaves or the mawali, they wanted to enter Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, Abu Bakr said first, those who came to Islam first, like those who were abid, slaves, and you enter first before Abu Sufyan and before the big people of Makkah. And they get mad. Abu Sufyan, he get mad. He said, these slaves, how you allow them to enter before us, even after became Muslims? And the father of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq said, yeah, Abu Bakr, how did you allow these people to enter before us? He said, because they came to Islam before you. They accepted Islam before you. They supported Rasulullah before you. That's why they are superior. What do you think? And subhanAllah, Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, he told them, لماذا ورمت أنوفكم واغتصتم? Why your nose became big and you became mad? Because they entered before you. And they started reciting, والسابقون السابقون أولئك المقربون. The foremost in Islam, those who all will be very near to Allah and His Rasul. يعني بلال وسلمان وخباب, the slaves before Islam, because they came Islam first, they entered before Abu Sufyan and those who came late after Fatih Makkah. They've been superior to Rasulullah and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this kind of arrogant people, those who are arguing without in right, these people also at the day of judgment, they're going to have this very bad punishment, torture in the hellfire, عذاب الحريق. والحريق, something, we say الحريق from burning. You want to burn something, put it, احرقها يعني, الحريق. When they make that big fire for Prophet Ibrahim عليه السلام, what happened? They put it for 40 days. Any bird was flying above this fire, they used to see this bird falling mashwi, being barbecued. It's ready to eat it. Because that fire was huge. But this kind of people, they will be in عذاب الحريق والعزب الله. Last ayah with me very fast, verse number 10. ذلك بما قدمت يداك وأن الله ليس بظلام للعبيد. Then it will be said to him, to this arrogant man, those who argue without any right, without any knowledge, without fiqh, without understanding, without a revelation. This kind of people without any knowledge, they argue, they like these arguments, they will be humiliated in the dunya, this world of life, and in the hereafter they will be tortured, and they will burn, Allah will burn them in the hellfire, and it will be said to him, this person, all this is due to what your hand sent ahead, and you are getting what you deserve by your acts in your life, and that Allah is not unjust to his servants. وأن الله ليس بظلام للعبيد. يبقى الخزي والعذاب, the humiliation, they will be disgraced in this dunya, this world of life, and the torture in the hellfire والعزب الله, because of what they used to do. Allah سبحانه وتعالى is so just. Allah is not ظالم. And Allah said in the Quran, وما ظلمناهم, we did not oppress them, but ولكن كانوا أنفسهم يظلمون, but they did oppress them, their own selves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers, He will never punish us without delivering the message to us. There is a crime and there is a punishment for the crime. He gonna warn you from the crime first. And after that, after warning you, He gonna tell you, if you make this crime, there is a punishment for this crime in the hellfire. And this is the job of the messengers and the prophets. And the Quran al-Kareem mentioned that. That's why Ahl al-Qanun, the people of law in this world, in life also, the law of dunya, they have the same thing. If you ask any attorney, you make any crime, somebody kill someone, or steal from someone, or cheat someone, and this someone, he went to the court and he saw him. Of course, he's going to look for the attorney, and the attorney, he knows the law, the system, the criminal, the crimes and its law and what's the punishment. That's why even in this dunya we have this. What about in the hereafter? The hereafter, Allah Azza wa Jalla already warning us in the Holy Quran about all of that. لا عقوبة لا عقوبة إلا بتجريم. There is no punishment without the crime. And ولا تجريم إلا بنص. I cannot say you are a criminal without law system. The system is telling you this is crime or not. The same thing with Allah also in the Quran and the Deen. Nobody gonna go to hellfire just like that. You make the crime, and Allah warned you. You get the message, and there is a hellfire, and the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم somehow he warned you about that. وما كنا الله سيدنا سورة الإسراء وما كنا معذبين حتى نبعث إيه رسولا. Will not punish someone until we warn him with the Rasul. He must tell him that. But that's why very important to understand that. And طبعا people they make their أفعال or action through what they say, what they do, and what inside their hearts too, like hatred, envy, and all of that. All of this against Islam. That's why, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ذلك بما قدمت يداك. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said your hand? Because of what your hand, subhanAllah, did. Because most of the problems are because of the hand. You can say it with the tongue, with your heart, but mostly with the hand. That's why Allah mentioned that in the ayah. Yeah. Jazakumullah khair.